So we've all experienced that feeling when we're nervous, right? An upcoming interview, a school presentation in front of our peers, a big speech for our company. Those jitters that we feel in the pit of our stomach is proof that our brain and our gut are connected. You know, it's no surprise that the gut is often referred to as the second brain because it has a nerve system with more neurotransmitters than the brain's central nerve system itself. Well, hey there, I'm Dr. Hagmeyer, and today I'm going to talk about the effects that stress has on the digestive system. All too often we throw this word stress around without really knowing what it does to our body, especially our gut. Well, if you're like me, you want to know specifically how stress affects the digestive system, right? I always want to know why. If we know the why, we can always backtrack and find a solution aimed at improving the why in the first place. And this is what I love about functional medicine. It's all about asking that question and getting to the root cause. Well, like I said, today's video, I'm going to get into how stress leads to many of the gut problems that we see people struggling with, leaky gut, irritable bowel syndrome, and so forth. One of the biggest problems that I see with patients who have irritable bowel syndrome or inflammatory bowel disease or even SIBO is this history or this a lifetime of stress and anxiety. These are, again, always common denominators. When we're stressed, our brain activates the sympathetic nerve system. And the sympathetic nerve system is really our fight or flight response. It prepares the body really to protect itself against imminent dangers for the purpose of conserving functions that aren't immediately needed for survival. And that should make sense, right? It's our innate wisdom of the body that's prioritizing what needs to be done here and now. Now, as part of that fight or flight response under stress, your brain is going to send signals to the adrenal glands, and that's going to instruct them to pump out a hormone known as cortisol and adrenaline. Now, during this fight or flight response, again, that stress response, if it doesn't help you run faster, run longer, fight harder, it's going to take a back seat. And that includes almost every aspect of digestion. Every aspect of digestion is almost shut down under stress. You see, our digestion is run by another part of our nerve system known as the rest and digest system. It's also known as the parasympathetic nerve system. It's the brakes. Have you ever heard of the vagus nerve or why it's important to perform exercises that activate this vagus nerve when you have gut issues? Well, this is why. We want to stimulate the rest and digest part of the nerve system, and we do this through vagal nerve exercises. Remember, the vagus nerve represents the main nerve of the parasympathetic nerve system, and it's the parasympathetic nerve system that really oversees things like mood, immune system response, heart rate variability, and even digestion. Think of the vagus nerve as the important vital connection between the brain and the gastrointestinal tract. And stress, again, puts a block on that vagus nerve. Stress hormones decrease blood flow to the digestive system, including the stomach, which in turn causes less production of hydrochloric acid. Less hydrochloric acid prevents our bodies from digesting proteins and fats. This basically, again, is the brakes on the digestion of proteins and fats, which, as you might imagine, the consequences, if we can't digest properly, are going to be things like bloating and feeling gassy and maybe even some acid reflux, maybe food allergies, maybe skin conditions and toxicity. And of course, with low stomach acid, we're creating the perfect environment for bacterial overgrowth. Again, low stomach acid is going to be caused by a decrease in these stress hormones. What else should you know? Well, number one is that the pH of the gut is designed to be acidic, right? And so this is one way in which many people will develop H. pylori infections. Now, once these bacteria begin to take over, you get an enormous amount of gas that builds up. It goes on to put pressure on the lower esophageal sphincter, or the LES for short. That in turn can cause a lot of problems with acid reflux, right? That heartburn sensation. Acid reflux is caused by the lower esophageal sphincter that's not working the way it's supposed to. It's not creating a nice tight seal between the stomach and the esophagus. Now, if you have acid reflux, you could have an infection with H. pylori, could have a problem with not enough acid in your stomach. You could have a problem with the lower esophageal sphincter not tightening up the way it should. And you could have problems with cortisol shunting blood away from the stomach, which in turn reduces the amount of stomach acid being produced. Another problem is something where we see problems with the ileocecal valve. Again, this is the valve between the small intestines and the large intestines. If you're bloated all the time, your ileocecal valve stays open. And this is how bacteria basically migrate from the small intestines, from the large intestines up and into the small intestines. You see, when this valve stays open, it creates this door and this pathway for bacteria to travel. And again, bacteria don't belong in the small intestines. They belong in the large intestines. But once the bacteria from the large intestines move up and into the small intestines, They set up shop, they start producing gas, they start producing either hydrogen or methane. And again, this can all be due to this fight or flight response. Again, fight or flight response is shutting this all down. So this is really how stress affects digestion. When the HPA axis is activated under stress, we get cortisol, we get adrenaline being dumped into the system. Again, this fight or flight state, we get changes in the alteration and types and kinds of bacteria that populate the microbiome. We get problems as far as permeability, right? We develop, our gut becomes more permeable, more leaky, and this can become a biological door into things like colorectal cancer and autoimmune diseases and a number of chronic health problems that we see associated with a leaky gut. We can also get thinning of the gut lining because of high stress and high cortisol levels, less mucus production. Mucus not only forms a physical barrier of the gut, but that gut barrier or that mucus is a big part of where our immune system hangs out. Stress can also change motility. This is why people with IBS suffer with both diarrhea and constipation. And again, not addressing stress or the adrenal glands is one of the biggest problems that I see for people who struggle with gut issues. And again, that's the connection between stress and how high cortisol affects digestion and acid reflux and bacterial overgrowth and gut inflammation and leaky gut and dysbiosis. So a few things and a few recommendations when it comes to dealing with stress and with gut digestive problems. Keep in mind that too much stress really just has numerous implications for digestive health. Symptoms like bloating and symptoms like constipation and heartburn and stomach pain. Again, those all could be signs that you're not addressing your stress responses. You have problems with the adrenal glands. If you have infections that keep coming back or small intestinal bacterial overgrowth that doesn't improve and it doesn't heal. And keep in mind that when I say, you know, it doesn't heal, it means you've got tested for it, you got treated for it, and again, on retesting, it's just not improving. That's what I mean when I say heal. If you're not healing based on changes on test results, it might be time to look at your adrenal glands and how they may be one of the missing pieces of your puzzle, another root cause in terms of why you're hitting a plateau. Well, there you go. I hope you enjoyed today's video. I hope it helps you understand a little bit more about some of these other pieces of the puzzle that so often stress can contribute to. Obviously, gut health and stress, very intimately connected. If you have questions about today's video, you can drop those in the section, in the comment section below. I'll do my best to answer those questions. If you have questions about becoming a patient and learning more about my big picture approach, you can visit my website. And lastly, there is a free guide that I put together that's called Your Guide to Troubleshooting Adrenal Fatigue. This guide is just packed with information as far as the role of the adrenal gland and how it plays into stress. And lastly, if after you give this video a thumbs up, I recommend another video that you watch in this series that goes over some of the important dietary tips on how to improve your gut health. Till next time, take care.